After you have planned your measurement strategy with your team, it's time to actually set up your Google Analytics account and begin collecting data. We'll cover creating an account and getting the tracking code, and then you'll practice making your own test account. While we won't cover every single configuration, we'll review the most common features that you should use to customize analytics for your specific business. When you first set up your Google Analytics account, you'll be asked to choose whether you want to track a website or a mobile application. Depending on your choice, Google Analytics will display instructions to add the correct code to collect your data. If you're tracking a website, you receive a piece of JavaScript code that you must add to every page on the site you want to track. It's best to add this code to the top of the page, before the closing head tag. If your website uses a template, you can add the code directly to the site template. If you're tracking a mobile application, you will download a mobile software development kit, or SDK, and share it with your development team. There's an SDK for the Android platform, as well as iOS. You can learn more about tracking apps in our developer documentation. Once you add the code to your site, you should start to see data immediately in the real-time reports. But there are other ways to add the Google Analytics tracking code to a site. One way is using a tag management tool. If you're unfamiliar with tag management, it's a fairly new technology that makes it easy to control and implement different types of JavaScript tags, like the Google AdWords tag, DoubleClick tags, or the Google Analytics tag. Visit the Google Tag Manager Help Center to learn more about this technology. In addition to tag management, some platforms also make implementation easier by providing plugins to simplify the tagging process. Plugins on sites like Blogger, WordPress, or Drupal simply require you to input your analytics ID into the administrative settings, and the platform takes care of the tagging from there. All right, now it's your turn to create a test account that you will use for the activities throughout this unit. Use the information in the lesson activity to complete the first page of the account setup process. If you have questions, refer to the resources in this lesson to get help. Okay, let's get started.